Police investigating TikTok video of boys pulling down pants of boys with special needs. Police in Fairlawn are investigating a TikTok video that allegedly shows two boys pulling down the pants of a boy with special needs here in Borough Park. Ah, boy, it's gonna be one of those videos where you get pissed off. Alright, let's go. Hello everybody, and welcome back to another video for the day. We're going back into r/iamatotalpos because everybody gotta get angry sometime. If you wanna show your support and be absolutely amazing, be sure to hit that like button, leave a comment down below and start up a discussion, and if you have not already, subscribe to the channel. Let's go. Ah, jeez, we're starting right off with something that would start a John Wick movie. We are really sad to say that someone came into the shelter Thursday for the food shelf and decided to steal out of the cash donation bin. We have reported it to the blank police department, and it is on our security cameras. We rely heavily on donations, and this is very disheartening. How petty do you have to be to rob the Humane Society? Seriously, there wasn't like a 7-Eleven nearby that you could just hit, but like seriously, no, this is something you just try to avoid, even if you're the bad guys. Watch Cuties on Netflix for yourself, and then apologize to, I have no idea how to pronounce her name, sorry. So yeah, in a nutshell, Cuties is, it's an 11-year-old twerking movie that's rated MA-18. Yeah, you get the idea of who the market for that was. Ain't that right, Netflix? This nasty thing is offended that I don't have a mask on. Freak your fatty, your Dr. Pepper is more offended than the beer virus. Okay, first off, don't bring drama around funnel cakes. Secondly, you don't just listen to the mandates, okay? And lastly, if you have the balls to make fun of somebody else's appearance, you better be ready for people to make fun of your appearance. Because if you're complaining about something petty, we all can assume you look like a Karen. We got another one. Great job, Trooper Blank. A pedestrian decided to matchlight the grass on Southern Route 512 and Southern Route 7. Citizen observed and alerted 911. After a short foot chase, one is in custody and one on his way to jail. I'm honestly really glad that they caught the dude because as of recently of the time I'm recording this, we're having to deal with the Western gender reveal party wildfire that, do not bring Michael Bay to your gender reveal party. It was not cool. You could have just done the balloon pop. Why did you have to do fireworks? And yeah, also, arson is a very serious crime. Lastly, who's that bored to think, oh, I got nothing better to do. Oh, look, some grass. I'm gonna set it on fire. Of course they matter, but I'm young and healthy, so you shouldn't care if I'm going to parties or to the beach with my friends, LMAO. Yeah, you know, just because I don't have the virus right now means I can't get it ever, ignorant. Just listen to the mandates and the lockdown announcements, okay? Oh, and just as a common reminder, the wearing a mask does not violate your rights. It's a dress code. And lastly, there's no medical exemption to wear a medical-grade mask. Do not come to Newburgh. You know it's really upsetting when you have people out there helping and you're begging for help with a horse rescue for 160 horses in Newburgh, only to find out it's a hoax. We had a convoy of over 30 trailers just showed up and nothing here. F you, dude. That's messed up. Yeah, you know, didn't you know, man? It's just a prank, bro, is the immunity card to make every single big issue nothing much. This has gotta be pretty close, if not right up there with swatting somebody. Hey, we got this big issue going on. We have people can help. Send them that way. Is anyone up that has a kiddie pool right now? Frankie was sprayed with a skunk. Why is he saran wrapped like that? She was in my Mercedes going to the nearest 24-hour Walgreens to have an emergency bath for getting sprayed with a skunk. I mean, I told her not to freak with the skunk. She had to be tied up for just a little bit because it actually worked, and my car smells only terrible and not intolerable. Look, I'm not showing the dog out of respect for the dog. Basically, the dog's tied up in what looks like its leash chain and saran wrap to the point where it absolutely cannot move. But yeah, absolutely immobilize your dog just because your cheap little Mercedes doesn't want to get dirty. The gender reveal party for the Statue of Liberty. It was a girl. Anybody who has happened to be watching this after the news about the California wildfire gender reveal party is irrelevant or forgotten. September 11th joke. Yeah. There really are just some things you do not joke about. Jude contending for the faith. Wednesday, 7 PM with John Randall. Church is open. What to bring? 1. A Bible. 2. A heart to worship. 3. Kids for children's ministry. What not to bring? A mask. Yep, you know, you get to go see God, and now you get to actually meet him. Woman witnessed a teen tossing firecrackers into George. There was a whole group of kids who found it funny to do this. Just as I was passing by them, I said, "Do you realize you've just started a forest fire?" And the kid said, "Well, what are we supposed to do about it now?" out? How about maybe realize that in something called a firework, it could start a fire? Seriously, somebody please help me understand how stupid you need to be to realize that the first half of something that you have might actually cause something that's it's related to the name, hence firecracker and fire. That's like one of my favorite Larry the Cable Guy jokes. It's like picking up a stripper named Syphilis and wondering what happened.
He can't turn his neck to the right.
He's making sure the ice cream van doesn't leave.
Oh, you must be really cool making fun of somebody's appearance, especially on the internet. Boy, oh boy, I hope you have nothing we can make fun of.
Because trust me, some people have the potential to rip you a new one in instant karma. Because trust me, I will get petty.
Probably very risque and controversial thing to say, but I genuinely believe mass shootings are an effective form of population control and shows natural selection at its peak, fight or flight. If you don't survive a shooting, maybe you are not prepared for hard life.
So please, Claire, enlighten me on what exactly is natural about somebody kicking down a door to a classroom and then unloading a clip of lead into you. Please do alliterate for everybody about how shooting is natural. How's getting a clip full of lead biological? And honestly, I really hope somebody reported your profile. And, you know, you to the cops.
Couldn't have done this without my coaches. Ah, the good old days before she happened. Hashtag swim life. Hashtag swimming. Hashtag party hard.
You know, I'm honestly not able to discuss what exactly Brock Turner did, but it really is upsetting that he was only in jail for about 3 months. I'm not sure how or why he got out. Maybe his parents bailed him out. I'm not sure why, but honestly, he should have been in there longer. Like, a lot longer.
This is probably TMI, but my husband and I separated after the death of our baby. He remains in North Carolina for his job. I returned home to Texas. Pray for us. Sending you prayers and love.
Death after vaccination?
Yep, that's right, Karen. You and your essential oils predicted the future. Don't you have a baby shower to go take a dump on or something?
It really wouldn't bother me if it were legal to exterminate liberals. Oh, so you want to exterminate an entire population of people because of their certain beliefs. Where have I heard that before?
Oh yeah, Germany during World War II.
Hey, I think you're cute.
Thanks. We should talk more. I'd like to get to know you.
Got you. This was for a TikTok. Nobody likes you. Bye.
Screw you. I hate it when people do this.
Hope you had fun trying to ruin someone's self-esteem for your little microscopic audience. What do you have, like 12 followers?
See, honestly, I hate stuff like this because one of the very first people to ask me out actually did it on a dare, much like this person did for the TikTok, and I hate them for that because they really ruined my self-esteem for the duration of grade schools.
So if you do in fact actually ask somebody out because you were dared to, you're a piece of trash.
Could you make the person that you were dared to ask out feel like nobody's gonna want to talk to them unless they are forced to?
Chadwick Boseman, Black Panther, celebrity, ghost box interview. Why did you
have to do this the day after he died? Seriously, is there no low that people will stoop for clout on the internet? See, it's posts like this that make me automatically think I'm gonna get angry as soon as I look into the subreddit.
24-hour overnight challenge in George Floyd's house gone wrong.
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna be censoring out the name of this because this pile of trash doesn't need any attention to his video. He doesn't need the clout, and he honestly doesn't need to have a channel. He's nothing but an insignificant troll trying to get a rise out of people by trying to clickbait people into a controversial issue. He's a small channel that's going to remain a small channel because he gets nothing but dislikes because the only content he can think is effective is controversial stuff that's going to try to troll people. But much like a clown itself, if you ignore them, they eventually go away. Because there's nothing big that's ever going to come out of this channel.
Boy dies after 9/11 dispatcher says, deal with it yourself. Okay, you know what, ma'am? You could deal with this yourself. No, this isn't a fake call. Do your dang job and send help.
I am really passionate about helping people during this pandemic. Going through my feed, I have seen many of lives affected by the virus. From businesses closing and to jobs roles changing, many people were not prepared financially for such a time. I want to make sure that you and your loved ones are taken care of going forward. So if you have been looking for an opportunity for extra income or if are struggling financially and don't know where to turn, send me a direct message for a solution.
Dude, did you just use the virus, the plague, to promote your MLM?
This is a public service announcement for all my fellow patriots. Just went to Walmart in this location without a mask. All good.
Okay, look here, Boomer. Let me tell you something. I'm not the biggest fan of wearing a mask myself, considering I have to wear one while sitting at a register for about 5 to 7 hours, depending on the day. And it doesn't exactly make working out the easiest thing to do when you get a face full of mask when you inhale. But you know what? Trying to contest this is the reason why we're the number one in these cases. You're part of the problem, dude. And with that, that is going to have to be it with the video. If you would like to show your support, see more videos like these, and all just in general, be absolutely amazing, be sure to hit that like button, leave a comment down below of something you'd want to see happen to the channel in the future, and if you haven't already, subscribe. I'll be sure to see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching, and bye-bye.